Hi students, welcome to the course on cyber security. Myself, Dr. A. Murali M. Rao, head of IT department, Indira Gandhi National Open University, New Delhi. This session, I would like to talk on digital infrastructure security. So the scope of this talk is that what is a digital infra, how a security can be enforced for digital security or digital resources, and how to protect the environment and some kind of remedial measures, and followed by so best practices to provide security. Let's see that what is a digital infra. The digital infra is an infrastructure which are deployed at network domain, security domain, system level, or call it a system domain, application domain, and data domain. These are all the five domains generally in any IT system to be executed in a networked environment. The digital infra is required at these five domains. Once again, I will again tell that the digital infra which are deployed at the network domain. At network domain, generally the routers, the switches, and other such devices are again, and its configuration files are the part of digital infra under network domain. Similarly, if you talk about even security domain, what are various security devices? The firewall, the intrusion detection systems, the intrusion prevention systems, antivirus, even a UTM, the Unified Threat Management device. These are all the devices which are to be deployed, maybe one, maybe combination at security device, a security domain. So again, these devices again comes under the digital infrastructure at security domain level. Similarly, if you talk about system domain, the devices are servers, systems, desktop computers, laptops, smart mobile devices, all comes under the system domain. Again, the set of files, the configuration files, even all these devices comes under again a digital infra under system domain. Application domain, again the software applications, software services, debit credit cards, passwords, and many other all are again comes under the various digital infra under application domain. And finally, the data level, the data domain, the database, storage, repository, this is also a digital infra considered as a digital infra under data layer or a data level. Why digital infra requires security? To protect the devices deployed at the network, system, application, and data or database domain from hackers and attackers. Ensures high availability of systems and services. Ensure business continuity. Secure data and data transmission. That's why digital infra requires security for all these things. How do we know again there will be a security breach? The violation in any of the following security parameters leads to security breach. Authentication, confidentiality, integrity, authorization, access control, and non-repudiation. So violation of any one or combination of these parameters leads to a security breach. Really, it is a very tough or a challenging to a system administrator or a network administrator, even an application developer, to know that there will be security breach or not. Why? Because in a general sense, suppose if some item is misplaced in a house, in a then it is easily, it can be identified and it will know that so something happened if it is misplaced. But in a digital world, it is very, very difficult to trace, to find out that even to identify something is lost unless the total functionality of the system gets down. However, see, the violation of in any of the following security parameters, like such as authentication, confidentiality, integrity, authorization, access control, non-repudiation, leads that there will be a security breach. So, what will happen if there is a security breach? The hackers will take an advantage of it to intrude into organization network, get access to server systems, applications and databases, steal and or delete the sensitive data for sake of fun or business discontinuity, deface the websites or web portals, inject viruses, trojans and many more to damage. Who is a culprit again? So, hackers or hacker or attacker is a person or a device through who or which to gain unauthorized access to the digital resources. Person is either internal or external to the organization. Report says that more than or most of the attacks or security breaches are done by internal staff of the organization. And how do we classify the hacker? So, white hat or a black hat. White hat is a ethical hacker, is a computer security specialist who breaks into protected systems and network to test and assess their security, use their skills to improve security by exposing vulnerabilities but not to do any damage. But whereas a black hat is a hacker who has the malified intention and violates security for a personal gain. There are so many cyber threats are there, like a malware, web-based attacks, web application attacks, phishing, spam, denial of service attacks, ransomware, botnets, insider threats, physical manipulation, damage, theft or loss, data breaches, identity theft, information leakage, exploit kit. These are all some of the cyber threats. Now, students, let's see that some attack vectors. Human element, web browsers, internet exposed assets, exploitation of vulnerabilities, misconfigurations, setup or missetup, network propagation, data leakage, mobile app stores, malicious USB drives, card skimmers. These are all some of the attack vectors where the hackers or attackers will use to start something hacking. See, what are different types of attacks? As I told you that in a networked IT system, in a network environment, it requires some components at the network level, system level, application level and data or database level. See, some different types of attack at network level are denial of service, we call it as a DOS, or maybe distributed DOS. Denial of service attack, we call it as a DDoS, IP spoofing, man in middle. These are all some attacks. Just for understanding purpose, I am just naming that some attacks at network level. Again, some attacks at the system level are password file theft, modification, deletion, or port sweeping, privilege escalation, Trojan horse. These are all some attacks and comes under system domain. And application level are session hijacking, SQL injection, session broken authentication, broken session management, insecure configuration. All these are all comes under application level. And data database level are data theft, modification, deletion and many other. These are all some different types of attacks under to be considered under network under various layers of a IT system in a networked environment. By keeping the increasing attack surface, again it is a challenging task to securing the digital infra. See, The increasing again attack surface, the IoT, mobility, online financial transaction, usage of more smart devices, social media, wearable technology, these are all again, of course, these applications are essentially needed, but at the same time, these applications are increasing the attack surface where attackers finding a new way to damage, to distract the digital infra. Some emerging threats again are hardware trojans, ransomware, IoT. If you talk about IoT, the Internet of Things. In Internet of Things, so insecure web interface, insufficient authentication, authorization, or insecure network services, lack of transport encryption, privacy concerns, insecure cloud interface, insecure mobile interface, insufficient secure configurability. These are all some of the vulnerabilities even under IoT. And mobile malware vulnerabilities, cloud technology vulnerabilities, and memory or even brain hacking. These are all, you know, some emerging threats by the hackers on the digital infrastructure. Again, some security challenges. Again, the maintaining security posture with changing business models and attack vectors. Continuously protecting across a dynamic threat landscape. Reducing complexity and fragmentation of security solutions. These are all some of the security challenges. How do we protect digital infrastructure? By deploying security devices and enforcing access control at network level, system level, application level, and data or database level. See, once again, one can protect the digital infrastructure by deploying security devices and enforcing access control. First one, at network domain, so the devices such as firewall or intrusion detection system, intrusion prevention system or antivirus to be deployed to protect network domain. At system domain, hardening the operating system, strong password and protecting the ports and all other comes under system domain. At application level, by writing secure code, that is call it as a defensive programming as part of software for a service. Use digital signatures and OTPs, one-time password for non-repudiation and more authentication. And at data database level, enforcing encryption during data transfer from source to destination and also at database end, at least on sense to data. In addition to that, control access and usage of network system and services. These are all, you know, that some ways where we can protect the digital infra. So for that, what do we need? A strong digital infrastructure security policy is needed. Systems and services should always pass through security audit before deploying in a real time. Systems should capture all events happened and store in form of log file for monitoring and to do postmortem in case of damage happened. Regular system and data backups are required to restore systems or services in case of damage happened. And redundancy also is required in form of internet service, internet connectivity. It means that more ISPs mean that more than one internet service provider is required to offer sufficient bandwidth and sufficient internet bandwidth. System and servers, applications and services, database and storage. So redundancy is required in form of all these things so that the business continuity can be ensured and also one can provide digital infra security. For whatever reason, some device or the other, digital infra got disturbed, damaged or hacked by a hacker or attacker, but at least the other side, because of the redundancy, the services will be always made available for the business consistency and continuity. Again, some emerging security technologies are blockchain, hardware authentication, user behavior analytics, data loss prevention, deep learning using AI and machine learning technique, and the cloud technologies are all some of the emerging security technologies to protect the digital infrastructure. Best practices to be followed at network gateway and system. Deploy security devices like firewall or IDS, IPS, UTM, that is unified threat management devices or antivirus to be deployed at network gateway so that adequate security can be enforced and assured. Enforce access control list time to time. Whenever the attack scenario changed, then the access control list to be also updated or added to protect the unusual things. And use standard operating system and hardening it. Enforce multi-authentication for at least sensitive application. These are all some of the best practices to be followed at network gateway level and system level to protect the digital infrastructure so that the business consistency and business continuity will always be ensured, and ensure that always the services uptime will be always high. Best practices at end user level are use strong passwords in all digital devices such as computers, laptops, mobile phones, tablets, and also change frequently. Do not disclose by the do not disclose to anyone, and do not select the option to recognize your password by device automatically. Deploy security devices that firewall, IDS or UTM, and enforce access control list. Use antivirus software and update time to time. Use standard operating system and update patches time to time. Controlled use of debit or credit card for e-commerce, and do not disclose PIN numbers. Apply always bare minimum financial limits at your internet banking account, and change on demand only. Smart devices are more vulnerable, which discloses your identity. So use as minimum as possible. These are all some of the best practices to be followed at end user level to ensure your digital infra more secure. And students, just I will wrap up this session on digital infra security. So just I talked about what is a digital infrastructure, which devices are which are comes under digital infrastructure. Because once we know the digital infrastructure, then only we can able to provide some security. So this just I touched upon what is different digital infrastructure deployed at network domain, system domain, application domain, and database domain, and also some emerging the increasing landscape just I touched upon, and some emerging threats, and also some emerging security technologies, and some best practices to be followed at system level and network gateway level, and also at end user level. See, I would like to conclude this as digital infra security is a continuous process but not one time activity. Security is process based but not product based. Students, I hope that you enjoyed this session on digital infra security. Thank you. Thanks a lot.